ranting lunacy, and this is a ranting lunacy. You know, why do you name it that? I want to get people's attention, I guess. You know, like they go to the store and have all the flashy ads, you know, and get people's attention. But anyway, Dispense. How can people afford? Let's say that they don't quite can afford insurance, but they need help. What can they do?
We definitely try to help everybody who comes in. Not everybody hears that, but that's what we try to do. We actually raise funds to help subsidize fees. We do charge fees for our service. We're a Christian ministry. We're an organization that provides, you know, professional counseling, and we want it to be accessible to everybody. So we raise funds just very intentionally to keep the center going and to help subsidize fees. We do take insurance, you know, but we're also, it's not just low-end or discount, you know, counseling.
It's not discount counseling. I've never heard it put that way before.
It's professional quality counseling that we want to make available to everybody. So we've got people who are coming in paying the full price, which is $100 a session. But we've also got people who are coming in saying, you know, I've got 3 kids. I was laid off from my job. You know, I lost my insurance. We're going to do everything we can possibly, you know, to get them in and to work with them financially.
Or you can refer them to somewhere that can help them.
If we can do that, and if they need to do that, yeah. There's not a lot of referral places around here, but if we can meet that need, we do. You know, we work with a lot of insurance companies, Blue Cross, Blue Shield, United Health. I can't even name them all. Cigna, Magellan, we take Medicaid, you know, which is Peach State and WellCare. And so we're definitely trying to work with people where they're at. And we also have a partnership program that we work with churches, to where we've got a lot of churches who help provide money or fees for counseling.
And you work across denominational barriers.
Oh, definitely. We're interdenominational, you know, and we do work, you know, pretty closely with churches. So I may have a pastor call up and say, I've got somebody in my office, they're suicidal, they're making very serious threats. The money's not the issue in that moment. It's how can we step in? But we've got a lot of churches who will say, you know, we'll pay for this many sessions, or we'll help you in this way, or we'll support you financially in what we do. We're a nonprofit organization, and so people who give to us...
Tax deductible.
People who give to us, the money does go to keeping the center going and to help and provide counseling for people who really need it.
Where are you located, and what's your number?
We are located 410 West Street.
It's 410 West Street.
Yep.
That'll be up on the screen, 410 West Street. And what is your phone number?
Phone number is 229-243-1633.
Say that one more time.
229-243-1633.
Okay, and they can call that. Can they leave a message?
They can call. If no one answers, you can leave a message. We'll get back in touch with you.
Can they say you have an email?
We've got an email, and we'll put that up on the screen. It's kind of long, so...
Okay. All right. Well, take care of that. Now, as far as affordability, do you get a lot of help with doctors? Do you get a lot of good feedback from doctors who are willing to help you out as far as taking patients?
Yeah, we've got a couple of doctors who we work closely with who, when we've got a client who does not have a doctor, you know, a family doctor or someone that they use regularly, we have doctors that will... help that. We'll do a referral. We'll help them set up the appointment, and then try to get them in as quickly as possible.
The reason I have to bring that up is because if they did need medication,
yes,
you would have somewhere to refer them to.
We've got 2 or 3 doctors, whether it's a pediatrician or it's a just general practitioner who does that. Yeah, and we'll contact them and set that up.
Have you seen a change in the last several years, even in how mentally ill is treated?
You know, I've seen some. You know, just with the healthcare system and the reform, you know, who knows whether it's going to come or not.
It's a lot different than it was 20 years ago.
It is. The way people perceive it is different. The way people approach it is differently. You know, one of the limitations we run into a lot of times is someone has insurance, they've been paying very faithfully, and their insurance will not cover mental health. Or if they do cover mental health, sometimes... there may be a cap, there may be a deductible that they have to meet first, and so they feel limited, and we're willing to work with. But sometimes, you know, we've got somebody coming in who is not something diagnosable like depression or bipolar or, you know, schizoaffective disorder, but it may be something like a very serious family dynamics you know, problem or conflict going on. Relationship problem that is not always diagnosable with something acceptable to
insurance. It will take some time to practice and you know, it takes practice to communicate.
It does.
It takes practice to parent.
Yeah.
Doesn't it?
It does. It takes a lot of practice to learn the skills, to put them into practice, to realize it didn't work this time and I'm going to try again and it'll work next time. And it takes a lot of self-awareness. Am I doing what I'm supposed to be doing? Am I aware of how angry I am? Am I aware of what buttons are being pushed in me? Am I aware of how I'm reacting to what's going on? Because if I can't catch that, all of my focus is on changing that other person, which...
I got an unusual question for you.
Sure.
Does your wife ever tell you to practice what you preach?
Not yet, she hasn't.
Oh, my goodness, you must have a halo or something around your head. Are you a saint?
No, definitely not.
Okay. Now, it's more focused on outpatient care now, isn't it?
It can be. You know, I mean, it depends on who you talk to, definitely. Everything we do is outpatient. There are a lot of great inpatient facilities that do work with people. But not everybody needs inpatient, you know. Not everybody needs outpatient. You really have to evaluate what is the need, what's going
severity
on.
Severity of the illness.
Severity of it, the immediacy of it. Let's deal with what's going on. Not just put them in because we can, but if they really need it. There are some issues that we as an outpatient center do not deal with just because we know we're not equipped. And the person does need inpatient care.
I want to tell from my experience, folks, if you're a man out there, especially, and you're addicted to pornography like I was, it was part of my manic disorder, bipolar disorder. And I'm not saying this will take care of the problem, but when I got into the hospital, the psychiatric hospital, and got on my medication, and after I got out and took my medication, that problem took care of itself. I don't no longer desire pornography. And people are saying, why do you want to talk about something like that? There's even pastors addicted to that, isn't there?
There are pastors. You know, addiction, no one is immune from it. No job or no profession makes us immune from it.
Especially men.
Especially men. Men are more visual. Men, there's something about that visual stimulation, which for a man, you know, and there's something about that creates that addiction cycle to where they're meeting that emotional need. This person, you know, who they're looking at on a piece of paper or on the screen is not criticizing, they're not putting them down, they're not telling them everything wrong with them. They go home and the wife may be saying, well, why didn't you do this, or did you do that, or can you take out the trash? Well, this person on the screen is not doing that. And so in their mind, it becomes a very easy way to feel better about themselves, to create that cycle that just goes around and around. The worse I feel, I come and do this and I feel better. And then they feel worse about it, which creates that cycle.
I can take your money, I can take your time.
Definitely.
An addiction can consume your life.
It very much can. There's a huge cost to it, which is not just financial. It destroys your relationships. Addiction to pornography, it affects the way you view other people. You start to...
You cheapen women.
Very much. You devalue people by saying, your purpose here is to make me feel good. Very self-centered. Self-centric motivation, which keeps it going.
Yeah. Well, the reason I brought that up is because I've got 1 minute, is because it's a bigger problem than what most people think it is. And so there's no shame. We got 30, 45 seconds. There's no shame in coming in and saying I got this problem. What is your number again?
We're located at 410 West Street here in Bainbridge, and our phone number is 229-243-1633.
One more time, 229 what?
229-243-1633.
Well, it's been good having you.
Hey, thank you for having me.
And stay tuned next week. We'll have a call-in guest, a minister turns atheist, Joe Holman. That'll be next week. See you later.